Welcome back, little ones. Glad you all could come back. Today we are on Job chapter 22, but before we do that, we'll do a little child's prayer. Hallelujah. Father God, we come to you and we ask you to please help us, Father God, to be good little boys and girls, that we will love one another the way you want us to, and that we will obey our parents, and that we will do whatever they ask us to do, and try to be good little boys and girls, and try to treat others the way we want to. Help us to do that, my Father. And we ask this, and help, and we thank you, Father, for our family members, all our family members, because we love them, Father. We love you, Father God. In Jesus' holy, precious, mighty name we pray. Amen, 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 hallelujah, amen. Well, Job 22, this is Eliphaz's third speech. What use are we humans to God? Job chapter 22, what use are we humans to God? Eliphaz from Teman said, what use are we humans to God, even the wisest of us? If you were completely sinless, that would still mean nothing to God all-powerful. Is he correcting you for worshiping him? No, it's because of your terrible sins. To guarantee payment of a debt, you have taken clothes from the poor, and you refused bread and water to the hungry and thirsty, although you were rich, respected, and powerful. You have turned away widows and have broken the arms of orphans. That's why you were suddenly trapped by terror, blinded by darkness, and drowned in a flood. God lives in the heavens above the highest stars, where he sees everything. Do you think the deep darkness hides you from God? Do thick clouds cover his eyes as he walks around heaven's dome, high above the earth? Give up those ancient ideas believed by sinners who were swept away without warning. They rejected God all-powerful, feeling he was helpless, although he had been kind to their families. The beliefs of these sinners are truly disgusting. When God's people see the godless swept away, they celebrate, saying, our enemies are gone, and fire has destroyed their possessions. Surrender to God all-powerful. You will find peace and prosperity. Listen to his teachings and take them to heart. If you return to God and turn from sin, all will go well for you. So get rid of your finest gold as though it were sand. Let God all-powerful be your silver and gold, and you will find happiness by worshiping him. God will answer your prayers and will keep the promises you made to him. He will do whatever you ask, and life will be bright. When others are disgraced, God will clear their names and answer to your prayers. Even those who are guilty will be forgiven because you obey God. Amen? God's willing, tomorrow we'll still on the book of Job. We'll be on chapter 23. It'll be Job's reply to Eliphaz. Today I complain bitterly. I love you all with the love of the Lord, and Father God loves you more. Please tell your loved ones that you love them. We're not promised tomorrow, not even the rest of the day. Tell them all about Father God, who is Jesus Christ in the flesh. And tell any and all that will hear you whatever Father God has given you. If he's given you a dream or whatever, because Father God is pouring out his spirit upon all flesh. So children, I know that some of you have dreams and stuff from the Father, and he tells you to tell your loved ones and tell people. So don't be ashamed. Be bold as lions and tell them what he tell you. And be obedient to your parents, please. And I hope that these parents are saved, because if your parents are living and striving for holiness, then you can teach your children. And you can bring your children up by the word of God, which is what he requires. Hallelujah. And each and every one of us, please live peaceable with all men. Children, please try and be good to others. Treat them the way you want to be treated, right? And don't be troublesome. Don't look for trouble. And don't be a troublemaker. Love all and treat them the way you want to be treated. Father God loves us all. And we thank you, Father. And I love you all with the love of the Lord. And Father God loves you more. You all have yourself a beautiful, blessed day from youngest to oldest alike. God bless you. Bye-bye.